Hello everyone and welcome to the Pencil Tutors channel. I'm Serfina and today I will be teaching the topic of inertia. This is Formpaw Physics Chapter 2.4. So without further ado, let's get started. First off, what is inertia? Inertia can be defined as the tendency of an object to remain at rest or, if moving, to continue its motion in a straight line at uniform velocity. Now, to help you understand this, let me ask you a question. Do you think it's harder to run in a zigzag motion or to run in a straight line? The answer is, it is harder to run in a zigzag motion rather than just running straight ahead. This is because our body has the tendency to retain its motion in a straight line, which makes it harder for us to run in a different direction, or in this case, in a zigzag motion. Now that is inertia. Whenever we talk about inertia, there's a law that's commonly associated with it. This law is called Newton's first law of motion. Now, Newton's first law of motion states that an object will remain at rest or move at uniform velocity unless acted upon by an external force. It is very important to know that the Newton's first law of motion is talking about the concept of inertia. Therefore, Newton's first law of motion can actually be used interchangeably with inertia. If a question does not mention the word inertia, but instead mention Newton's first law of motion, you must know that the question is still discussing about inertia. The only difference is, inertia is the concept, while Newton's first law of motion is the law. When we're talking about inertia, an important thing to know about inertia is its relation with mass. Now, the inertia of an object is only affected by its mass. The bigger the mass of the object, the higher the inertia. For example here, this bowling ball has a higher inertia than the soccer ball because the bowling ball is heavier and has a bigger mass. An adult person would have a higher inertia compared to a baby because the adult is heavier. This is the most important thing for you to know about the concept of inertia. Next, let's look at some examples of inertia in our daily life. Have you ever noticed that when you're in a car and it starts moving, your body will flung backwards? This is because of inertia. When we observe a vehicle that is moving from rest, the passengers are usually thrown backwards when the vehicle starts moving. This is because the inertia of the passengers keep them at a state of rest. When the vehicle stops moving, it is observed that the passengers are thrown forward. This is because the inertia of the passengers keep them at the state of initial velocity, just like when the vehicle was moving. Another example of inertia in our daily life is a ketchup bottle. Now, usually when the sauce inside is almost empty, usually we would give the bottle a quick jerk that would force the sauce out. And this is possible due to inertia. When the bottle moves, the sauce inside of the bottle would move together. Then, when the bottle suddenly stops, the inertia of the sauce retain its initial velocity and keep the sauce moving downwards and out of the bottle. Now, to help you understand inertia, let's answer some questions together. The first question shows water flowing out of a tank from a moving lorry, and it asks, what happens to the inertia of the lorry? Now, since water is flowing out of the tank of the lorry, then the mass of the lorry would decrease. As we all know, the bigger the mass, the higher the inertia. So, if the mass decreases, the inertia would also decrease. Therefore, the answer is B. Next question. The diagram shows a coin falling into the glass when a paper is flicked off. The coin resists moving together with the paper, and this can be explained by... Now, when the paper is flicked off, the coin resists moving together. This is because the coin retains its motion at a state of rest. Therefore, this could only be explained by D, the concept of inertia. The last question asks, which of the following types of vehicles has the biggest inertia? Just like I've mentioned, inertia is only affected by the mass of the object. So to find the vehicle with the biggest inertia, you have to find the vehicle with the biggest mass. Therefore, the answer to this question is A, the ship, since it is the heaviest and has the biggest mass. Now, that is all for my lesson today. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to like this video and subscribe to our channel. Don't forget that we post videos every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday covering the subjects of physics, mathematics, and biology. Thank you so much, and I'll see you guys around.